Hey guys, so today we'll talk about NPV, which is one of those basic tools that investors use to decide whether or not they want to invest in a company or a new project. And we'll also touch base about inflation because it's very important in this conversation. All right, so what is NPV? It stands for net present value. And in simple terms, it's pretty much what is the future worth of money, the value of money today. And it's defined as the sum of all periods N of all the cash flows that you have divided by a discount rate. Now, discount rate can mean a lot of things. Most of the time, it means the inflation rate, I, as you see here. But if you're a really cool investor, it also means other investments that you can make. Something safe, for example, government bonds is something that investors like to invest in. And here, period T everywhere just means that it's a year or a month, but usually it talks about years. So let's talk about what exactly is inflation. So the common definition is it's the general increase in the prices of a basket of goods. What is a basket of goods? It means the average composition of what you buy. So, I mean, not necessarily one thing. So your favorite bottle of shampoo, for example, can cost $2.99 3 years in a row. But if you take average prices of all the things you buy, they increase year by year. So let's look at an example. So in the year 2000, if you had $100, in 2020, you would need $151 to buy the exact same thing, which is pretty crazy if you ask me, $50 in 20 years. So let's calculate the US dollar inflation rate. How would we set it up? So we have 100 times, we open the parenthesis, 1 plus I, we don't know I, that's what we're looking for, to the 20th power, because we have 20 years, equals 151. So if we rearrange the equation, we see that I equals 151 over 100 to the power of 1/20 minus 1. And that roughly equals 2%. So we can say that the average yearly inflation rate of the US dollar is 2%. Great. So some notable examples of this that I'm sure you've heard of. In Zimbabwe, about 12, 13 years ago, they had an 80 billion % inflation rate, which is ridiculous. That means that prices were doubling every day. So if you go out today and buy some milk for $20, then tomorrow that same gallon of milk will be $40, and the next day it'll be $80, and that's just, it's crazy, got out of hand. That's, I'm sure you saw some memes of banknotes with like 100 million Zimbabwe dollars. And the same thing is happening in Venezuela recently, where it's only about 6 billion % inflation rate, only about, as if that's not a lot. And prices are doubling every few weeks. And I'm sure you've also seen where people are making clothing out of banknotes or baskets or any other types of goods, because something as simple as a handbag made out of $100 million notes is worth more than the actual banknotes, which is crazy. But that's what happens when you print money. So you can't just go out and print money. The money has to be backed up by something. So let's take a look at our business idea. Let's say that somebody approaches you and you're a cool investor, and they ask for $10,000, and they say that every year you'll get a profit after taking account all the costs, all the salaries that you have to pay. After all that, you get $2,500 back every year. So at first glance, you think, wow, it'll only take 4 years to break even. Is that really the case? Is this investment worth it? Well, let's take a look. Back to our NPV, net present value. If it's more than zero, that's good. That means that in the long term, we'll make money. If it's less than zero, obviously that's bad. We'll lose money. And in the rare case that it equals zero, that means we just broke even. We didn't make any money. We didn't lose any money. That's just, we're back to zero. I'm back to square one. So let's take a look at how this model will be set up. So once again, we have our formula for NP. We have the sum of 4 years, because that's the prediction that our business guy made. We have the cash flows and we have the discount rate down below. And as we calculated before, we said that the inflation rate is 2%. So how does this look? So the initial cash flow that we have is minus $10,000, because that's the $10,000 that we're giving to somebody. And then we have plus the cash flow sums in the future. But notice here now we have one instead of zero, because in the zeroth period right now, we just rewrote it here. We have $10,000. And then the $2,500 discounted each year. And as you can see, it's minus 10,000 plus 2,500 divided by 1.02 plus 2,500 divided by 1.02 squared, because it's now 2 years in the future and it's a compound inflation rate. And same with the third and fourth year. And if we draw this table, this is actually how much money we're going to get each time. So as you see, we're going to lose $480 if we do this business idea. So even though at first glance it looks like we're going to break even in just 4 years, actually it's going to take longer. And if we only do 4 years, then you'll end up losing future money, because the $10,000 that you have now is worth more than the $10,000 that you'll have in 4 years because of inflation. Now for homework, I'll tell you this. What if instead of $2,500, each year the return was $2,627? Would you break even or not? Tell me, and we'll see if you're right or not.
Want to learn more? Check out the next video. Quick reminder to subscribe to Geekly.edu.